it looks like we've got a handle on this whole leadership thing for the time being.
Yeah, hashtags MP, leader, and let's go have been trending on social for the better part of 48 hours. So
okay.
I'm impressed.
Right, hey, but can your source find out Videl is still trying to trade a rising young star with leadership abilities up the wazoo?
Oh, don't talk about yourself in the third person.
Yeah, he plays terribly with boomers, and that's our most affluent demo.
And don't say wazoo.
And don't dodge
Thank
questions.
You.
It's not that funny. I mean, I really want you to work your source here, Ricky. You know? Or does Teresa from Ticketing still have insights?
It's not Teresa
from
Ticketing,
man.
Look,
you're
going to
tell
me.
You're going to tell me.
Look, just because you're doing a great job right now does not mean you can let your foot off the gas.
Mm-hmm.
Look,
mm-hmm.
I will try and see where Othello's head is at, but you still got to do your thing, all right? But nothing's settled on the trade front.
Of course, man, but it only gets better from here, Rick. Trust me.
All right, well, you know, it might be a good idea for you to check in with Coach Graves, too.
Yes.
I mean, he's an ally on this one.
Yeah, I do chat with him every day, but... You know, maybe I can see what if he knows what Othello's thinking of doing.
Good. Good. In the meantime, I'll hit up my source, and we'll take it from there. One day at a time, right?
Yes, sir. Only way to do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to NBA 2K23, career of Moses Pope, MP. We're gonna talk to Coach Graves now.
I gotta talk.
Hey.
Yeah, man, I was about to say what's up. But, you look a little bit upset.
There's no easy way to say this, but, you're out of the starting lineup.
I don't understand why.
It's beyond my control.
But you said you would help me if I stayed out the press.
I can't help you.
Okay, how? By doing what about Della tells you to do?
Ernest! Get over here! MP, I'd like you to meet Ernest Templeton.
What the?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, man. What exactly does Ernest here do?
He's one of the brightest young stars in our analytics department.
Analytics? Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
He came up with the formula for teammate grade, our new all-in-one performance metric.
That was you, man? Yes. Do you like it? Yeah, I read the documents up on it. Makes a lot of sense. I'm just excited to see it in action.
When you see yourself going up for posterizing dunk, what do you see? A unicorn flying over a rainbow. What I see is a series of zeros and ones in the beautiful pattern of a Wolverine raining down on his opponents. It's mathematical. Inevitability. I've been working on it for a long time.
Long time, huh?
Yeah, 89, 99, 2009. Time doesn't exist.
It's been extensive research, but we'll spare you the details.
Spare you the details.
Needless to say, it's the new gold standard.
The
lawyer wants us to use it as a central pillar in all player evaluation.
All of these things. Teammate grade. This is how we change the narrative. How are you going to achieve a better grade than the starter that's currently in place? Here's how you're going to do it.
Hit those goals,
I'm looking
no choice but to start you.
The
boy will say to himself,
I got you, coach. Okay,
enough, Ernest. We're all pulling for you, MP.
We're all pulling for you, MP.
We know you can do this.
Wait, all right, I'm going to get out of here. But I got you, coach.
I got you, coach.
Okay, like I cut the thing. I wasn't able to see what I got to accomplish here.
So my favorite cards in the game right now are the Pink Diamond John Wall, just because he can play, you know, pretty good defense for his size, and I like his jump shot, and then obviously he can dunk the ball. All right,
well,
that's real important right now.
Let's get
and,
it.
I'd say,
gentlemen,
Thomas,
let's get it.
He's got a really nice release and has some dribble six to make the game smoother and just fun. He's just a really fun.
Here we are, ready for a game against Phoenix Suns. We're out of the starting lineup. We met Ernest. Whatever the hell his last name was. This is going to be fun.
And so in the game for the Bulls, in it forward, it's DeRozan and Williams. Ball runs point with Levine flanking him. And it's MP in at the five, roaming the paint.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift.
That's Chris Paul. Oh! Oh, I blocked him! Oh, I blocked him! Let's go!
Chicago
Levine, go, baby.
Here's Levine.
I was off. I was trying to hit a tree. What am I doing? There you go. Who's that over there? 30. Next guy. There you go. I'll take the assist. Down by one. Get that out of here.
Second chance shot, and that's 2 points on the layup.
I don't know what the hell that was, but I got my own rebound.
Extra effort on the glass. Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's three straight buckets at the rim. That's
look at that. Get it, bro. Get it.
Now Shorich. Bridges outside. Pass to Craig. Fires the three. Take a look at the Suns' performance here, guys. What are your thoughts?
Well, it's simple. I mean, they started off strong, and they've been hot from beyond the arc since the get-go.
And as long as the threes are dropping, you've got it.
Bro, that was a terrible pass.
On the court right now, second quarter for the Bulls. Levine is the two, with DeRozan at the three. Then he is out there with Andre Drummond, and it's Dragic in at the point guard position.
Great decision-making for Booker, realizing one of his guys is open and makes the pass to him.
The 2K drive. Well worth a second look.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. I love the attack mentality in the post game. The Phoenix Suns have been a completely different team since acquiring Chris Paul. He's the leader of this team, and he helped set the tone for defense. Even if they saw the step back coming, the defense didn't offer much resistance.
Here's MP. And that one falls. His fifth pass in seven tries.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. That's why they continue to get attacked.
For the city of Phoenix, really embracing Chris Paul as soon as he arrived.
Yeah, I mean, he's in the latter stages of his career now. But you never know it based on how hard he plays every single night. He just makes everyone on this team so much better.
It's stolen by Johnson.
Okay, I don't know what the hell that was. That was one of the worst passes I've ever seen in my life.
Booker, pass to Payne. Six on the shot clock. Down low. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. Bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
And his ability to officially score, that's really helped him out in this one. Putting them ahead on the scoreboard.
Crowder, he's checked. Suns. Chris Paul comes in for Payne. Williams is checked in for Chicago. Lonzo Ball comes in for Giants. And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Thanks a lot, Brian. Well, the Bulls are a force once again. Zach LaVine said, quote, it's a new team, a new mindset, and I'm always confident. Step on the line, throw the ball up.
Assist tonight.
And you know, in this quarter, they've really brought up their shooting percentage.
And MP throws it down.
Because he draws so much attention on the offense, the D, look, they're going to have problems with LaVine, and it opens up some great passes.
Well, Grant, one thing LaVine has done since entering the league, he's taken his strength training very seriously.
No question. I mean, he can play a much more physical brand of ball now.
That was all ball, bro. We're coming out now. No, we're staying in. Look at that. And that was all ball, too. I poked the ball.
Phoenix making some changes. Charge comes in for Aiton. And Craig subbed in for Shaman. Green's check in for Chicago. The Sumu comes in for LaVine.
Yeah.
Stolen by MP.
Come on, Lonzo. Come on, Lonzo. Run the field, Lonzo. There you go.
Perfect pass to set up the lay-in.
Run the court. On the field.
Their offense is really humming right now. And it's because of the
shots to fall here in the second. The Sumo on the wing. MP, that one's good. MP's got 16 points now.
Doing more work in the painted area. He has really excelled inside.
Craig against Green. Bridges, he's checked in for the Sun. And a change for the Bulls. LaRusso, he's checked in for Ball.
Substitution.
We got one away left in the second quarter. Pass to Bridges. Shot clock at 5. Rebounded by Green.
Nice defense.
The Bulls have gone an outstanding 7-7 so far in the second quarter. LaRusso misses.
That's the shot they wanted. It just didn't fall.
It's tough to watch those miss. I'm sure they'll convert the next chance.
Here's Sharks. He can't get it to go. Green with the defensive effort. Chicago trailing here. Pass to DeSumo. Here's MP. Tries again. And he takes it up. And
there
lays
go.
It in. MP's got 12 points now in the quarter.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations. Getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Caruso against Paul.
We played the whole second half. Coming off the bench.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. Well, Richard, you have a long playing career. When you think of the great leaders you were around, what are some of the common threads?
I think one of the common threads are the guys that work the hardest expect the most from their teammates. That's something that I've always seen being very consistent with leaders. Both leaders, especially leaders in professional sports, you have to lead by example.
The deadly pair of Paul and Booker on backcourt. Bridges and Crowder holding down the forward spots. And it's 8 in at the 5. That's who's out there for Phoenix. Pass to Paul. Bridges.
Savage is outside. And here's Booker. To the middle. Here's Crowder. That one's good. And the assist to Booker. Crowder's got his second basket of the night. In a tight game, they wanted to make sure of that possession. Yep, that one goes. And the Bulls lead by three.
You can see his confidence on that shot. DeMar DeRozan catches it.
Back on draft night 2017, the Bulls trading away their star, Jimmy Butler. And what a haul they got from Minnesota. Zach LaVine, the headliner, and he's turned out to be a franchise player. It's tough to win one of those type of deals, but Chicago got a stud.
On the wing, MP. He's guarded by Bridges. And Mikal Bridges picks up the foul. That's foul number two.
A minute and a half left in the third quarter. Pass to MP. Here's the Sumo. Right now averaging 5.5 a game. Here's MP. And again, Chicago, no good.
Not what I wanted to do, honestly. Get that out of here!
Gotta love how they've been crashing the boards.
Right back, Russo. Let's go!
He throws it down. And once he gets to the rim, it's fairly automatic. Nothing fancy right there. Just takes 2 points. Moves over. 3 seconds separating the shot game clocks. Outside Johnson.
Probably gonna stay on the bench. Oh, look, we came in with what? Literally, coach, you bring me in with 6.3 seconds left.
Yeah, no one better to make decisions.
We're taking our last fucking shot. Let's go. Come on. Come on, Lonzo.
They stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul. Yeah, just a must-foul situation to stop the game. Good on the first. That puts him up 5.
Lonzo Ball taking 2 shots.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. And it's a 6-point ball game.
Making no mistakes and putting some extra nails in the coffin right here. That pretty much did.
Phoenix calls timeout. They're losing by 6. Just 4 seconds left.
They're looking there. Trying to get a lead here. You ain't gonna win the game.
Not an ideal situation for them. They've got to make a 3, then foul, hope for some misses, and make another 3.
I would see the star of the game with 7 points. I have 24 points.
Booker for 3. He can't get that one to fall.
That's it. We got the win.
Squeezed out the win here on the road. The NBA, the visiting team, is always under some added pressure. But they made it work and got the win. Whatever the margin may have been. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. We'll We'll see you next time.
We got a Kia endorsement. Let's get it. Woo! Bet. Thank you. I got $350 for the event. Easy money.
Thanks, MP. Can you tell us about the decision to move you to the bench?
Ooh.
Eh, I ain't got too much to say. I mean, but when coach make a decision like that, it's to, I guess, help us play better as a team. You know, so I've got to trust him on that choice. You know, luckily I can't come off the bench and still be effective, which I plan on doing, so it's cool. You know, that's where I am for now. But that ain't gonna last long.
You know, it's tough for me to see the logic behind your benching from a performance perspective.
Exactly.
I mean, is there something going on behind the scenes that we don't know about? Maybe like a disciplinary action situation?
No.
There's not?
No.
Okay.
Great.
If you say so.
Thanks, Nate. Whoa, take it easy, Naylor. You about to jump out of your seat. What's up, brother?
Well, how do you respond to the reports that Athela Akpan is not hanging up the phone and other teams ask about your availability, man?
Whoa.
Okay, how do I put this? Everyone has a job on the team. And Athela's job is to explore every option to improve the roster.
But wait, you don't think that you've earned a reprieve from trade talks with your recent play?
No, I mean, not really. I mean, people are going to ask about you if you're playing well. That just comes with the territory, bro.
I mean, but there are stars in this league that are off the table without question.
Okay,
right now, you're not one of them.
Oh, okay. Listen, fam, I don't compare myself to other people like that. If my team is winning, I'm good. So that's what I'm all about. That's it. I don't listen to all that outside noise and chatter.
You heard it here. You heard it here, ladies and gentlemen. You heard it here. All right, let's hit up the neighborhood real quick before we wrap this episode up. Looks like we got a spooky wall for my home court. We unlocked it. So we're gonna head there. Hit up our phone, which is vibrating, and wrap the episode up. You guys enjoyed it, hit the like button. Subscribe if you're new, and always be sure to ding that bell. Remember the no contents that I upload. Who hit me up? Tomas. What's up, Tomas? Okay, he's going to be watching me in the upcoming games. My court real quick. See what the hell this spooky wall is. Customize my court. This one, right here, New York City skylight. Where the hell is this spooky one? Oh my goodness, I guess this one right here was it, right here. There you go, that's much better. We were supposed to play on one-on-one with one of these guys, Quest Journal. Yeah, my court. Time to win a game against Rodney. Play a quick game here against Rodney. Wow, you're gonna... Oh, I reached in. Okay. Move! Get that out of here! We just blocked the shit out of him. Oh, man. Let's do this quick now. Let's just outrun them. Get all the points we can. Let's try a quick three here, ready? Well, that's gonna be off. We gotta get it. I don't have the good jump shot. That's why it was way off. Get that out of here, Rodney. Well, you got the ball back. Really, bro? Ladies and gentlemen, we're back for that. I just cut that out because that was a game. All right, you did enjoy the episode. Be sure to smash that like button. Remember, we're watching the video. Subscribe. Ding that bell. Do all that good stuff. For me, quests are updated. Let's go. Oh, we gotta get the. We gotta get that reward. Talk to Rodney on the platinum deck. Let's go talk to him real quick. You guys do all that good stuff for me in the process. And, yeah. We'll see you for the next game. Who are we gonna go up against? I don't know yet. We got a starting event here. But where's Rodney at? Rodney, where are you? Oh, you're over there. I see you. I'm a coming. We're adding that badge right now. Talk to Pippa on the silver deck. We're going to talk just about everybody here quick. Let's talk to Sakara. We talk to Pippa. Say you better not have froze on me. Here's Pippa. Emily. All right, we gotta talk to a few people. Let's go do all this stuff. Go back to the trips. We gotta talk to the other people. We can wrap this episode right up shortly. Talk back to Rodney over here. Told me that. You didn't have to text me. Where the hell's Emily? There she is over there. Alright. Well, I'll see you guys in the next game. If you did enjoy this episode, once again, hit that like button, subscribe if you're new, and ding that bell. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace.